According to statistics from the World Health Organization, 50% of COVID-19 deaths have had non-communicable diseases, and 33% of the world death toll annually is caused by non-communicable diseases arising from the consumption of foods containing trans fatty acids. In the bid to achieve the World Health Organization global target of eliminating trans fatty acids from the global food systems by 2023, the Uganda National Health Consumers Organization has embarked on a move to awaken the Parliamentary Forum on Non-Communicable Diseases to advocate for policies to eliminate foods rich in industrial trans fatty acids from the market of Uganda and East Africa.
Parliament is reactivating the Non-Communicable Diseases Forum, and this is the forum that worked with us on the Tobacco Control Act. We are looking at regulating trans fatty acids, which is the industrially produced acids. And we know that the East African Federation is a very good thing, but there is continuous and extensive exchange of goods and services.
Advocates of food safety have called upon Parliament to enact the National Food Safety Act to ban inclusion of trans fatty acids in edible foods. Some food products like margarine, Kimbo, Cowboy, among others, contain hydrogenated oils, which experts contend to be harmful for human consumption.
The bill we need is an act pushed by Parliament which eliminates or bans inclusion of trans fat acids in our food system. Those are edible oils, the cooking oils, which would actually harm. And they don't just harm human health, they also harm our traditional food systems.
They propose a 100% excise duty tax against trans fatty foods, which tax they want to be ring-fenced to finance treatment of non-communicable diseases and the National Health Insurance Scheme.
Fatty acids should be charged 100% of tax, because they actually don't just harm human life, they also affect other life, such as animals, because when we consume animals that have consumed trans fatty acids, we are also harmed as a result, and that affects.
Robina Kitunji Kaitiritimba, the executive director of Uganda National Health Consumers Organization, quoted members of parliament to scale up laboratory services at health center 2 level to give people access to tests for deadly chronic diseases at early stages that is manageable.
Government needs to work with the parliament, minister of health, to be able to see that we improve the services to the rural communities on testing, laboratory diagnosis. Many people die because they do not have the testing equipment. By the time you get to hospital, the disease is advanced. We need government to strengthen laboratory services.
The chairperson of the Parliamentary Forum on Non-Communicable Diseases, Dr. Nicholas Kamara, who represents Kabale Municipality, committed to take up the matter of raising awareness of dangers in trans fatty acids and also push for necessary legislation.
This area of trans fatty acids is not an area which is known so much in Uganda, but I know that the countries like Norway reduced by a third their cardiovascular premature death by just removing trans fatty acids from Norway. It was just a simple intervention which reduced cardiovascular death.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.